Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. So in my last two videos I have shown you how to make the open herringbone or the closed herringbone and how to make the closed herringbone in a shape like this. Now just to give an idea, suppose this is your dress neckline. You can also make the closed herringbone around it like this, just to give that extra flavor to the neckline. So this obviously is a very small shape that I have drawn here of the neckline. Your neckline is going to be much bigger, but I'm only going to demonstrate how you can use this very same stitch around your neckline to make it look a little more attractive. So let me show you. So this, suppose, is the neckline. What I have done is I have drawn a line parallel to that, and I'm going to work the closed herringbone on that line. You can also use the open herringbone, it's entirely your choice, whether you want to make it dense or whether you want to make it look spaced out. That is your choice. So the method remains the same, once on the right side and once on the left side. Just that now we are going around the neckline, which is a U in shape. And you can use this for any shaped neckline. You can use it for a V neckline, or a square neckline, or a U shaped neckline like this that I have drawn, or a square shaped neckline, whichever. You just have to draw one line parallel to the neckline and work the open herringbone on that line. Similarly, not just for dresses, you can also use this to decorate your handbags or clutch purses, because this is a very fast stitch. I mean, it works up very fast. You don't have to spend more time on the design if you're using this stitch. So it's a very quick and fast stitch that can be worked up easily, and it just adds that extra flavor to the dress or to the purse, or suppose you have a mobile pouch, so for that you just give one line like this and it is good to go. It looks good. Or if your daughters have a hairband, a cloth hairband, you can maybe work this stitch on the edge with a contrast color so that it looks different. Just mentioning the ideas that come to my mind while I'm working on this. Once you reach the end, you can go down. Pass the needle from under the previous stitch. There's a loop that is formed here. Now pass the needle through that to form a knot. And now you can cut the thread and your design is ready. Thanks for watching.